And now, taking control with Dr. Josh.
As we complete another anniversary of the 9/11 tragedy, we are reminded of just how devastating the losses were for so many people coping with the loss. Unfortunately, it's a part of life, though. Joining us today to discuss how we can cope in a healthy way is UAB psychologist Dr. Josh Klepo. Thank you so much for being here with us today. And on this just very tragic week, as we look back, the images were just so horrible. I mean, so many children lost their parents. So many spouses lost their loved ones. So how can we deal with this?
It was horrible. It's tragic. It's extreme. We're also dealing with the loss of our ambassador to Libya. Mm-hmm. And as extreme as these examples are, they remind us that we have to figure out how to deal with it. A lot of times people are not very good at coping with loss. And so it's something that, you know, it's a part of being healthy, and there are strategies that you can use to make sure you get through in a good way.
Well, let's talk about some of those strategies. What do we need to do?
The first is to recognize that it's okay to tell other people about the loved one and what that person meant to you. A lot of times we kind of pull back. We don't want to burden people with the loss, but sharing those feelings is important not just to you, but to others around you. Now, related to that are the feelings themselves. You have to be prepared to have very strong feelings that's not always sadness. Mm-hmm. I mean, people think about being sad, but what about the fears, the anxieties, the anger, the frustration? Those are emotions that you're going to experience, and you kind of have to just accept it versus trying to push it away.
And you also need to take care of yourself and take care of your family, too. I mean, that's very important. A lot of people do forget to do that.
You have to, because those strong emotions wear your body down. Mm-hmm. And if you don't take care of your physical health, if you don't get the sleep, and if you don't eat right, etc., then you know what? You're not going to cope as well. So paying attention to your physical health is important for the healing process.
And also important to reach out, help others dealing with a loss. That's why support groups are just so important. You not only help others, but it ends up helping yourself too.
Yes, you're still dealing with the loss, but it's kind of a distraction, but it's a productive distraction. And that's something that's really important. And as you said, you're also helping other people.
And the last tip, remember to celebrate the lives of your loved ones.
Closure is important, and closure is really hard, but memorials and rituals help bring closure so that the healing can actually end and doesn't get prolonged and go on and on and on.
All right. Well, unfortunately, death is a part of life, and tragedy happens. Thank you so much for joining us.